I'm going to repair the circuit board of this mini split air conditioner and check why it is not able to start the compressor. I am supplying electricity to this circuit board. As soon as the electricity passes through, the light turns on and starts blinking. The relay is also switching, which means that all the functions of this circuit board are working correctly. This circuit board shows a P4 error. I have made a video about P4, where I explained what faults could be present in the circuit board. The same faults might not all be present on this circuit board, but at least one fault will be there. I will provide the link to that video at the end of this video. Today, I will specifically test the low side of this circuit. The high side of the circuit is working perfectly fine. If the microcontroller itself were faulty, this circuit board would not display the P4 error. The P4 error is shown only after the microcontroller outputs the signal, indicating that the circuit board is unable to start the compressor and needs to be checked. To repair this circuit board, we need to know the IPM number, which will help us easily find the datasheet. The IPM number is FSBB30CH60. By looking at the datasheet of this IPM, we can easily understand the low side pins and see what each pin does and what it is used for. Besides this specific number, there are other IPMs with the same number but ending in C or F. If the IPM's number ends with these two letters, they are essentially the same. The only difference is the manufacturing dates and generation. The functions remain the same. Let me explain that the design of each numbered IPM can differ, and their functions can also vary. This is because the arrangement of the low side pins is kept different for each IPM. The rest of the IPM's workings are the same. However, due to the different arrangement of pins, we cannot replace one IPM with another of a different number. There can also be differences in the shape of the IPM, which is significant. Therefore, we need to use an IPM that matches exactly with the original one. Now, let's look at the pin arrangement of this IPM. The first pin starts from the left side. This pin should have a positive 15 volts, which is used to operate the IPM. If these 15 volts are not present, the IPM will not turn on. The second pin is the ground pin. As you may know, a circuit is not complete until both positive and negative connections are present. The ground pin provides a pathway for the 15 volts to complete the circuit, allowing the IPM to function. The next pins are 3, 4, and 5. These three pins perform the same function, but they are controlled by the microcontroller, which turns them on and off. This is because separate ICs are installed on these pins. When signals come from the microcontroller, they create low voltages here. The generation of these low voltages causes the IGBT's low side to turn on. In this way, the voltages, in the form of positive and negative signals, are generated and sent towards the compressor. Next are the 6, 7, and 8 number pins, which are used for detecting faults. If there's a problem in the circuit, these pins pass signals to the microcontroller, indicating issues like undervoltage, overvoltage, or a short circuit. These pins alert the microcontroller, which then shuts down the IPM. The next pins are numbers 9 and 10. These two pins are used for high voltages. Pin 9 is used for high input voltages, and the microcontroller controls it by turning it on and off. However, pin 10 is a common pin, where 15 volts should be present. If positive 15 volts are not present on this pin, even if the microcontroller is sending signals, the absence of voltage here means the IPM's IGBT won't turn on. These 15 volts go into the IC inside the IPM. The microcontroller then sends signals through pin 9, and when 15 volts reach the IC via pin 9, the IC provides voltage to the IGBT. This turns the IGBT on and off, generating the necessary voltages for the compressor. And this is how the compressor operates. The next are pins 11 and 12. These pins, along with all the other external pins, serve the same function. They receive 15 volts and function to provide feedback to the IC inside the IPM regarding the output going to the compressor. This feedback helps determine how the compressor is being driven, its position, and its speed. These three sets of pins, or these six pins, along with the three capacitors, perform this feedback function. Now, let's talk about the internal pins in this IPM. There are two pairs of these pins, and they are also high side pins, similar to the operation of pins 9 and 10. These pins have the same function, so we need to check for 15 volts on these pins, also on these pins as well. While working on this circuit board, it's helpful that the company has labeled the voltages in many places. This makes it easier to test the circuit board. This is the indoor unit that I have powered on, and it's showing 17 degrees on the display. The outdoor unit is here, but I've directly attached the indoor unit's wires to the circuit board. You can see that the circuit board is operating. I have connected two multimeters and an analyzer to it. This multimeter is for checking the AC voltages of the outdoor fan motor. The other multimeter is showing me the communication signals, indicating that there is no problem in the communication.
20 minutes later.
It's been quite a while, and the communication on the circuit board is also working fine. The circuit has even turned on the outdoor fan. However, after trying to start the compressor for a short time, the indoor unit displays the P4 error. After that, it resumes normal operation, then shows the error again. You can see that the display shows 17 degrees again. It will keep doing this repeatedly. I have turned the circuit board back on. Let's check the voltages to see if they are correct. As I mentioned, the first pin, which is on the low side, is where we'll start. I'll place the red probe on the first pin and the black probe on the second pin. The reading shows approximately 14.60 volts, which means everything is working correctly. The next three pins are ground pins. I'll place the probe on one of them. The reading shows 14.60 volts on these pins as well. This means these pins are also working correctly. The next three pins are fault detection pins, and they can have voltages ranging from minus 0.3 volts to plus 0.3 volts. The seventh pin should have 5 volts, but they are likely in the millirange since they are used for current detection. We can't check the voltages on these pins, so let's move on to the next pins. The voltages on pin 9 come from the MCU, but we'll check for 15 volts. I'll take the ground voltage from the high side pin of the IPM. There should be 15 volts, and indeed, there are 15 volts present. The voltages from the microcontroller to pin 9 are approximately 0.67 volts. You can see the IPM trying to turn on, as indicated by 2 millivolts from the MCU. I'll check the next pins. They show 1.9 millivolts. This last pin also shows 1.9 millivolts. So the voltages are reaching the low side pins of the IPM, but the IPM is not starting. Now, let's check for 15 volts on these pins. There are voltages present here. The second pin also shows 15 volts. So this means that the MCU is doing its job correctly, but the IPM is not turning on. Now let's check which voltages might be missing. We should find 15 volts across these three capacitors as well. If the ground is absent, then there won't be any voltage either. Let's check for 15 volts on this pin. The last pin is ground, and the adjacent pin should have positive 15 volts. Here, we have 15 volts. The next pin also has 15 volts, and the following pin also shows 15 volts. Now let's check the voltages across the capacitors. So this way, we can determine if the ground is present and also check the positive voltages. There's no voltage on this capacitor. Let's check the next capacitor. No voltage here either. The third capacitor also shows no voltage. However, when we take the ground from the high side pin, we get 15 volts here, but not from the capacitors. If there are no 15 volts from the capacitors, it means the ground is absent. When I place the probe on the low side pin of the IPM, you can see that the ground pin isn't showing anything. The next pin also isn't showing any voltage, and the pin after that isn't showing anything either. This means that the ground for the bias voltages is absent. There is a disconnection inside the IPM, which is why the ground is not present here. This is also why there are no voltages on the capacitors. The IC inside the IPM is not functioning properly. Now there are two methods to address this issue. The first method, which I will describe, is not very sophisticated. It involves directly providing a ground here, but since the disconnection is inside the IPM, directly providing ground won't be effective because the ICs won't receive the ground. Therefore, it's not a useful solution. The second method is more proper, replacing the IPM. If the IPM is replaced, the problem will be resolved. I have now removed the IPM from the circuit, and I will solder a new one in the circuit. I have turned the circuit board back on and placed the analyzer with it. I also replaced the IPM in the circuit. You can see that the analyzer's light briefly turned on, and the circuit board attempted to start the compressor. Since the compressor is not installed with the circuit, it cut off the voltages. I'll check the circuit with the unit. I started the indoor unit, and the outdoor unit also started. The outdoor fan motor and compressor are running. All IGBTs in the IPM are on, as indicated by the lights on the analyzer. To ensure proper testing of the unit, I'll show you a method to run the unit for a longer time. I haven't connected the refrigerant lines to the indoor and outdoor units. To avoid a load on the compressor, I used a loop. This way, the compressor can be tested temporarily. Remember to open both discharge and suction valves. If you are willing to support the channel, you can buy me coffee. For that, visit Patreon. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.